Hi Aries, welcome to October 2018. This is Meraki the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and I'm from India. This is going to be for Aries Sun, Moon and Rising. It's a 10 card Celtic cross, and kindly make sure that you understand that these are the general readings. They may not apply to you, or a part of message will apply to you and the rest may not. Take what you what you feel is meant for you and leave the rest. Also, don't forget to apply your own intuition, and because energies are fluid, so it may happen in October or before October or after October when you are listening to this video. I already have flippers for you, Aries. I have the Empress and the Five of Cups. First came out the Empress and then the Five of Cups, and the bottom of the deck is the Father of Swords. So what I'm seeing here is that that you were feeling very much in control about certain things. You felt that you had a lot of authority over something, and then you felt like you could give to other people, or you had a lot to offer to other people. In a nurturing sort of way, or you are missing someone who was offering you a lot of support and nutrition, or lot of advice even, and a lot of nurturing, but this person is probably not there anymore in your life. Or you were someone like this for the person that you were dealing with, and now that person has left your life, for whom you have done so much, but still I feel that if you have done something for this person that is not there anymore in your life, you still feel very, very abundant. You don't feel like something has been taken away from you, because nothing actually can be taken away from you. You are only a instrument through which universe works. So yes, you have probably offered somebody your help, but now I'm feeling that you are being very, very stern about how much you can do for a person. I'm also getting here that you can be dealing with a Taurus individual or a Libra individual, or if air sign like Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, but these are not important. The zodiac signs are not so important, but you may be dealing with people of these signs. Let me see what else comes up. What are the messages for Aries for the month of October 2018? What are the messages for Aries for the month of October 2018? What do they need to know? So you are going through some transition in your life, Aries. You could be dealing with a Scorpio person. It can be Sun, Moon, Rising. It can also mean that you have been through a death of ego, or you have been going through a death of certain kind in your life, like death of basically, to my mind, it's coming death of ego. It can be death of anything. It doesn't mean literal death. It just means that there is a part of you that you thought was you, but it's not there anymore. You realize that you have to grow and you have to change in order to in order to be better version of yourself. Now, what I'm also getting here is that bottom of the deck is the Justice card. So whatever is happening as it was supposed to happen, and how the karma is working is like karma is in balance. So don't fear the change that is taking place in your life. It's going to be for your benefit. So what is going to serve you is that if you shed the skin of that snake goes through transformation. So if you shed the skin quicker, without any reluctance, without any resistance, then that would serve in your interest. Otherwise, it will take you some time to basically resurrect and to transform. And it's okay to take your own time, but sometimes people get stuck in a stage where they are not able to come out of the past. So try to be wary of that. Don't get stuck in past. What I'm also getting here is the Daughter of Wands and the Judgment card. So these are major arcana, Empress, Judgment, Justice, Death. So I'm getting here that whoever is watching this video, you are going through something very, very significant when it comes to a spiritual side of you, because Judgment, Justice are karmic cards. Death was about transformation, and it can feel like you are feeling very uprooted from your old self, and you feel like there needs to be some justice done, or someone needs to be forgiven or forgotten. So either you are trying very hard to forgive someone or yourself about something that has happened, and you are trying to even gain justice because you feel like something was imbalanced, something was not balanced in the past. So you are striving to get that equal exchange of energy. So if you were investing in something that was not giving back equally, you are now going to stop that, and you are going to forgive the situation or the person that you are dealing with, because it's not worth you know, hanging on to it anymore. You want to fly above all that. And Daughter of Wands is telling me that you are slowly going to get into your power. This is a fire element, so either you are dealing with a fire sign again, or a Scorpion again, because this is a Scorpio card, or then a Libra person. So what it is telling me is that someone might be feeling physically attracted towards you, or you are feeling physically attracted towards someone else because they're charismatic and good looking. But what I'm also getting here is that someone is very, very focused on their dreams and desires. They don't care about your dreams or desire. This can be you or the other person. So someone here is very, very focused on what is at hand, rather than the emotions, or they are basically action oriented. That is what I'm getting here. I'm also getting a message that someone is trying to be the alpha, or you know, alpha version of themselves, or something like alpha, omega, beta, something of that sort. Like someone is upgrading is what I'm getting here. Now let's see what are the messages with regards to Aries, October 2018. What are the messages for Aries Sun, Moon, Rising? 10 card Celtic Cross. Excuse me. Guys, I'm doing tarot reading after June, July, August, after 3 months. And you are the first sign that I'm doing, because you are the starting, of course. I hope this resonates with you guys. I took a break because I wasn't feeling very well. I had something going on in my own personal life. If you had booked reading with me back in June and I had disappointed you in some way or the other, I'm really sorry. I did not mean to. I'm not saying that I have. I don't think I have. But I remember in June, I did a couple of reading that I was not fully satisfied with on my own. Like, I did not feel up to the mark in those readings. So that's why I stopped doing readings, because I felt I needed to take a break. So let's see what's coming in for Aries. Daughter of Swords. So this is the center energy. I'm getting that someone here is very, like someone wants to bring you a message, or you are waiting for a communication, or there has been some harsh or blunt communication. Now this could be someone who is a little bit immature when it comes to expressing their feelings and emotions, so they will just blurt whatever comes into their head and whatever. It can be a air sign, someone who is very sharp with their mind and tongue, not so emotional. It can be you or the other person. What's crossing you is the Five of Wands. So I'm getting that the challenge is that you are very like, your thoughts are not focused. as it should be, or you are getting distracted by all the competition that is happening around you, or there is someone that you are interested in who is being very, very cold, because probably their attention is divided. They are getting attention from a lot of other people. So that can also be the case here, because I'm getting that there is a lot of scattered energy. Either this person is very, very, you know, like they are not focused with their energy. They are giving attention to a lot of people. So that can be a cause of concern for you. You feel like you have to compete for this person, or it can be a job that you are competing for. So yes, there is some competition. This card is coming up again as the root energy. So whatever is happening, like I said, this is the justice card. Whatever is happening, it's happening because of the karmic situation or the karmic backlog that you had. You could be dealing with the Libra person, definitely. Justice is telling me here that either you are seeking justice, like I said, or you are dealing with a professional here, like a lawyer, doctor, who takes no nonsense approach. Because they are very serious about their work. This can be you or the other person. And this person is very, very focused about formalities and stuff like that. And they don't want to get unstable. They don't want to get thrown off their path. I'm also getting here that if you are seeking divorce, some of you, I think that is coming up here, like someone is divorcing someone, or you are thinking about it, or there has been some sort of a situation where there is some separation going on, which is what I'm getting here. Something is coming to light, like what is right, what is wrong, like it is being made very, very clear, black and white. Some of you are searching for the truth, so you don't care if this truth is bitter or not. You want it. That is what you are seeking. But I want to tell you that there is a lot of karmic energy here. So it might serve you well if you just let things unfold and don't take them personally. And if you feel that it's not serving you, just drop it. Don't hang on to it. Because karmic stuff is very hard to deal with. You have to let go of it as soon as you recognize that there is something beyond your control. In past, either you had extended love offer to someone, or some sort of offer to someone, or you were given an opportunity somewhere, which either you missed an opportunity, or you offered somebody something and they denied it. Like they did not take your offer. So this is coming up because someone was either greedy and they wanted more, or they were not happy with what they were being offered. It can be you, like you were probably not getting the salary that you desired, or something of that sort. So you denied it and the opportunity was let go of because it was not fulfilling. What's crowning you is the Father of Cups. So what I'm getting here is that someone is very emotionally balanced. I think in your head you are very emotionally balanced. You understand the emotions behind the entire situation, but you don't want to succumb to your emotion. You want to be very you want to take a very rational approach. This can also be someone like a water sign. Scorpio, Pisces, or a Cancer, someone very much mature when it comes to handling emotions and understanding them. Father of Swords in future. So this is what I'm feeling here, that someone is very, very, very professional about their work. They want to get to the truth. They want justice. They want no nonsense. They are very, very serious with their emotional investment. They are very cutthroat when it comes to being taken very seriously. So either you are going to be like this in future, who takes no nonsense, because this is in future. So yes, someone is just not taking any bullshit anymore in future. this card is coming up again as you. So this is you coming up in your reading as the Empress. This was a flipper before I started your 10 card Celtic cross. So the Empress is telling me that you feel very abundant, you feel very self-dependent or self-sufficient. In fact, you have so much that you can offer to other people. And you want to make sure that whatever you are offering is reciprocated. You don't want to just give. You want to receive as well. So you are trying to maintain balance with respect to reciprocity. Yeah. So give me a moment. Yeah, so you want to be not the only one investing. You are wanting something in return for whatever you give out, which is good. Now this is the card again which is coming up. This card also flipped out for you before I started doing your 10 card Celtic cross. So this is the other person who has left the situation feeling very heartbroken. This person is really sad. So either you can offer this person a lot of comfort because you have lot of things to offer. So maybe you are thinking about how can I offer this person comfort, because this person is emotionally hurt and someone around you is emotionally hurt. I don't know who this person is, but it can be a child as well who is hurting due to separation of their parent. So yes, I'm getting that. And this person can be in depression and you have a lot to offer to this person. So if you are generous and you are capable, then I will suggest to reach out to this person. Don't be cold and don't give them tough love, because I'm getting that you don't want to show your emotions somehow. I think you are trying to be very hard on this person or someone around you. So yeah, just be mindful of that. I think you are doing all this, you are being very stern and strict because you have been betrayed in past, and your fear is that you will get betrayed again. That's why you don't want to invest anymore. That's why you don't feel like delving into your emotional side, because you feel that you will be butchered like you were butchered in the past. So you were betrayed in the past and that's your fear, and it is holding you back from living from your heart. So you don't want to open your heart. So I think you need to listen to heart chakra meditation music in order to heal your heart chakra, open your heart chakra. Yeah, do try that. And once you do that, your outcome card is the Chariot. So either you are dealing with a Cancer person or you are finally feeling very relieved and very sorted, like my mind, my soul, my everything is in, my spirit is in balance. Moon is your mind. Here is the moon. Your moon and your spirit, everything is in balance, and your physical self, this is the physical self, materialistic self, everything is in balance, and that is when you can move forward with full force, like you know, like a stallion. So in order to do that, you need to first align yourself, mind, body, soul, and work on yourself, integrate yourself to achieve whatever you want. And what you are going towards is, where are you heading? You are heading towards 10 of Pentacles. Yeah, so you are heading towards 10 of Pentacles, which is bliss, marital bliss, home life. Like you are trying to achieve a wholesome lifestyle. Like you want to live a lifestyle of your choice, your dream. So you want to have a lot of pentacles, which is money and resources, like material resources. So you're accomplishing that, and that's why you have probably taken a very professional focused approach towards manifesting your desires and dreams. This is the house card. Some of you are probably moving house and you are shifting, or you are offering someone a commitment regarding building a, starting a new family. But someone here is holding back their emotion or trying to be keep their resources to themselves. Like they are being a little bit miser. That's why I said open your heart chakra, because if that is you, then you are not doing yourself a favor by cutting off from your emotion. So yes, that was your reading, Aries. I hope it helped you, and if it resonated, please drop me a comment, because I would love to hear from you. Have a really, really nice October. See you again. Bye.